Bam, that's true. In this video, we're going to continue our discussion of solving two-variable, non-linear systems, finding out like things where lines cross parabolas and hyperbolas cross whatever. So, this time we're going to do the addition method. So, for the addition method of solving a system of equations, and it sounds very similar to solving linear systems, because it is, you're going to organize your like terms in columns. You're going to make a pair of opposite numbers occur in front of the variable which you wish to eliminate when you add these equations and then continue the process. Add equations and solve for the remaining variable, back substitute, and then finally check your answer. We're going to do two examples to see what this looks like in practice. So here we go. The first example might look very similar. It's the first example I used in my last video about the substitution method. This is also going to work for the addition method because we can create an opposite pair of numbers, add them, and get an equation with only one variable. So we're going to, I'm just going to change this first equation a little bit in the sense that it's nice if you get the terms all stacked up, not only, you know, where you're at, you know, where you're all your, not only your x's and y's are stacked up and in columns, but the degrees are also in columns because, you know, 4x squared is not a like term to 4x. So now we're going to use a multiplication. You might have to manipulate both of your equations, or in this case just one. And if I multiply the second equation by 2, did I copy this right? Yeah, we're going to multiply by negative 2. Because I already have a negative 2 in front of the y, and if I multiply by negative 2, I can have a positive 2 in front of this y, and when I add my two equations, I will have a sum which only has one variable. So, we're going to put that negative 2 through there and get 4x squared minus 2y equals negative 3, and negative 2 times 4 is negative 8x, and negative 2 times negative 1y is positive 2y, and then negative 2 times negative 4 is positive 8. With all my columns nicely organized, I get 4x squared plus 0 is 4x squared. 0 plus negative 8 is negative 8x. The negative 2y and the positive 2y will cancel out. Let's just cross those out there. And negative 3 plus 8 is equal to 5. Get that equal to 0 by bringing the 5 over with subtraction, and we get 4x squared minus 8x, bringing again it's positive 5, so we're going to bring it over with subtraction, minus 5 equals 0. Now, if you didn't watch the other video about substitution, this is slightly difficult to factor because my leading coefficient is not equal to 1. So I'm going to take my leading coefficient and my constant, we're going to multiply that together, and get 4 times negative 5 is equal to negative 20. And again, we're looking for factors of this product, negative 20, that not only are factors of negative 20, but also add to negative 8. And those factors are going to be positive 2 times negative 10. Those not only multiply to be negative 20, but they also add to be negative 8. So we're going to bring this up and get 4x squared. And now I'm going to use these special factors to break apart the middle term. We have positive 2x and negative 10x. Minus 5 equals 0. We're going to factor out at 2x from our first two terms and get 2x. 4x squared divided by 2x. 4 divided by 2 is 2. X and 2x divided by 2x is 1. Bring out a negative 2 and get negative 5. Negative 10 divided by negative 5 is 2x. Negative 5 divided by negative 5 is positive 1 equals 0. We have this common factor here, which is what we need when we're factoring by grouping. And we get 2x minus 5 and 2x plus 1. We're going to set each one of those equal to 0. bring the 5 over with addition, divide by 2, bring this 1 over with subtraction, divide by 2, and get our two values for x. We're going to plug those into one of my original problems here. This is getting to be a bit of, let me just clean this up. This is our original problem. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to take these values of x and plug them in and solve for y. So, let's take a piece of orange chalk, and we get 4 times x, which is 5/2, minus y equals negative 4. 4 divided by 2 is 2, 2 times 5 is 10, or 4 times 5 is 20, divided by 2 is still 10, either way you look at it, minus y equals negative 4. Subtract both sides by 10, and negative y equals negative 14, and that means that y is equal to positive 14. So, my first coordinate is 5/2, comma, 14. Now, let's take a piece of green chalk, plug this number in, and get our other intersection point. Again, plug it into this easier second equation. So we have 4 times negative 1, 1/2, that's the x, minus y, equals negative 4. 4 times negative 1/2 is equal to negative 2. Add 2 to both sides. Divide both sides by negative 2 and negative 1, and get y equals 2. So our second point is going to be negative 1/2 negative 1/2 and positive 2. Let me check to make sure I've written the right thing. Yes, I have. Now, we believe these to be the two intersection points. To make sure, you need to take this x and y value and this x and y value and plug them both into the first equation and both into the second equation to make sure that, you know, these actually are the solutions. If this point does not check off for both equations, it is not a solution. If this point does not check off for both equations, it is also not a solution. But they do check out, and so let's get this erased and get to our second example. Our second example. Now, if you haven't studied conic sections yet, you might not know that this is a circle because you have two squared terms and they both have the same sign and the same coefficients. This second line where we have x squared minus y squared equals 36, this is not in the standard form for this conic section. But when you learn or study conic sections, you'll find out that this is a hyperbola. It opens up like this. It kind of looks like two parabolas going in opposite directions, though they're not really parabolas. So we have a circle and some form of a parabola, and this one, because the x squared is positive, is opening sideways or is a horizontal hyperbola. And let's see if these intersect. Let's see if we have any intersection points. You might have 2. We might have 4 because of all the square rooting and getting the two possible answers, or we might not have any. Okay, so, addition method. We need to multiply one, or maybe possibly work with both equations to create a pair of opposite numbers in front of the variables we'd like to get rid of. Well, the y squared terms already have a positive 1 and a negative 1, so this is set up to just start right off the bat. We just add them and get rid of the y squared, so this is ready for our addition, and there's no need to create these opposite coefficients. So, 1x squared and 1x squared is 2x squared. then negative 6x plus 0 is still negative 6x, and negative 5 plus 36 is 31. We're going to bring that over to the other side with subtraction, and we get 2x squared minus 6x minus 31 equals 0. Okay, if you want to attempt to factor this, then you're going to take the first leading coefficient and the constant, multiply those together. We get negative 62. That's a rather large number, so it might take a little bit of effort to do this, but if we can find factors of negative 62, you know, it's negative, so one will be positive and one will be negative. So we can find factors of negative 62 that add to our middle term of negative 6, then this quadratic is going to be factorable. Turns out that it's not. We have, let's see, we got 1 and 61, or 2, I mean, excuse me. So negative 1 and 62. So I could, you know, I could flip-flop the negative, but 62 and 1, 62 minus 1 is nowhere near 6. We could say, well, what about, let's see, 2 works. How about 2 and 31? Well, 2 times 31 is, well, you know, 1 needs to be negative. So negative 2 times 31 is negative 62, and negative 2 and 31 do not add to be negative 6. And indeed, 31 is a prime number. So there are no other factors of 62, and so there are no factors of 62, negative 62, that will add to our middle term of negative 6. So this is not a factorable quadratic, which means we're going to be doing the quadratic formula. So the quadratic formula, in case you forgot, is x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And so we're going to try and work that out. Well, our quadratic equation is in standard form. The powers are in decreasing order, so this is a is 2, b is negative 6, and c is negative 31. So we have x is equal to negative b, which is negative 6, plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4a, which is 2, c, which is negative 31, all over 2a, which again is 2. Okay, I'm going to need some notes for this. At least I will shortly. So we have x is equal to, the two negatives cancel out. So we have 6 plus or minus the square root, negative 6 squared is 36. Negative 4 times 2 is negative 8. Negative 8 times negative 31. Let's see. Well, the two negatives are going to cancel out and make it a positive. 8 times 30. 8 times 3 is 24. So 8 times 30 is 240. And now an additional 8. So we have 248. Double check. Yes, we do. All over 2 times 2, which is 4. So we have 6 plus or minus the square root. 248 plus 30 is 278, plus 6, 278, and 6 is 278, 284, double check, or 248, excuse me. 248. I'm looking at the wrong line. Oh no, I put my stuff in the calculator before, you know, whatever, I'm going a little bit farther than I did my calculator. Let's double check that. 248, 278, 284, yes. All over 4. Now we're going to put this in the calculator. 6 plus square root of 284 over 4, and 6 minus the square root of 284 over 4 comes out to the values of 5.7 and negative 2.71. So far so good. It seems like we're going to actually have a solution to the systems. So we're going to take these values and back substitute them into one of these original problems just to make sure I can follow my notes, because I can't do all this in my head. I use the second equation to try and continue the problem. So back substituting, remembering that these are x values, I didn't write that all the way down. Let's try the first one. So we have 5.7. So 5.7 squared, again using the second equation, minus y squared equals 36. That comes out to be 32.5. Minus y squared equals 36. Subtract both sides by 32.5. We get negative y squared equals, should be what, 3.5? Yeah, 3.5. So divide both sides by negative 1, and y squared equals negative 3.5. Well, I am not going to be able to square both sides of this equation and get a solution. I can't square a negative number unless we start considering imaginary values. So this 5.7 is not a solution. If I come back up here again and try the negative 2.7, let's see here, blue, negative 2.71, that's going to come out to be negative 2.71 squared is 7.34 minus y squared is equal to 36. That's negative y squared equals 28.7 after I subtract both sides by 7.34. Divide both sides by negative 1, and guess what? I'm going to try and square root a negative number again, which means that this number does not work either. So my last example is trying to find the intersection point between a circle and a hyperbole. You may not have learned that yet. But they don't intersect. We would call this an inconsistent system. Basically, if you were to graph these either by hand or with a graphing calculator, in my pre-calculus book, we had not studied conic sections yet. I'm actually going back to previous chapters that our county said I could skip. My students would not know this is hyperbole yet, but we have two hyperbolas, opening horizontally, and somewhere, I don't know if it's in the middle of those or somewhere, there's another circle and they're not intersecting, so there's no solution. Bam! Go do your homework.